But it was a rough night. It was like we heard the winds. My daughter and I were in the closet. My son and my father were not in the closet, so I can't force adults, you know. But it was rough, and that closet was not about every bone. But anyways, we survived, and that's the most important. So this is the front. See right here how we couldn't fit any more plants and stuff inside the garage. We have no electricity. They're talking about us not having electricity for maybe a week or more. I'm praying to God no, because I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't have a generator. And see here, maybe, so I don't know. I will do my best. So here is all the debris. My little lemon tree that has beautiful lemons. It's kind of tilted and everything, but it's still stuck to the ground. Ventured out here. No, we still have the fence. A lot of people fence. There is a big tree here that I want you guys to see. It fell in front of their house. I feel really bad. I heard that they were. They left the house because they were so scared. Let me show you here. Do you guys see this house? And how this tree really went to the front of their house. It is really sad. That's a really big tree there. That is very huge. So, see? Right there. And it just goes into their front of their house. So, but that was the only big tree that I really saw that knocked down. We are blessed because I had, as you can see, we have a lot of big trees in my house. And the one in the back was really scary, too, guys. That was pretty scary. So, let me go ahead and pause this, and I'm going to take you guys to the back. Garage. It's a complete mess. Please bear with us. That is going to be our stove, our gas grill. I was blessed to find. See, everything is toppled all over there. Thank God that they didn't cave in here. So, that's a mess. But the propane tank, thank God I found one. So I was so blessed because Hurricane Matthew, we weren't so lucky to find one because the lady bought up seven and never looked at my son once and said, here, have one. So anyway, so look at this fence. It's a little wobbly, but it could be straightened up, so it's no big deal here. So let me take you around to the back so you guys can see. My dog does not have a playground anymore. So this is here. That's fine. She can't be in the backyard anymore. We're going to have to take her out for walks, which she loves anyway. But this is the back. Totally like this, there was a fence panel there. Really sucks, look at that. But again, we got our lives and our houses intact. That's the most most important. Wood, you can just pick up wood. Hopefully that we will find wood, because a lot of people use these panels to board up their homes. So the sad part is that orange tree. When we moved in here, the kids were little and we planted that. And it gave some wonderful sour oranges that, you know, we used. But yeah, I'm going to have to chop that down because that's totally to the ground. Let me take you around here, because since that fell, it took down that other part of the fence. So, see, and you can see my neighbors, and everybody too, had the same fate with their fences. They're kind of old, older homes, older fences. So, yeah. But other than that, we're pretty much blessed. See here. I was so happy though that this which used to be really bad. My brother-in-law straightened that panel, that door. So that was good. So you see people how they boarded their homes. Right? So luckily, thank God, nothing happened. My dog was very faithful last night and she never left our side. Chili! Chili! See? You see Miss Chili? She's our faithful little noble steed. And this tree was fine. In the back is just like this little thing that fell down. See right there? No biggie. And here was more water, but it receded, thank goodness. So no flooding, guys. And that is the tour of the house. And we are alive and we are blessed. And thank you so much for all you guys, for all the love and you know, comments wondering how we're doing. So we survived it. It's fine. We have a curfew till 6 o'clock p.m. today, September 11th. And to all the victims of September 11th, God bless everybody and God bless them and have their souls up in heaven, each and every one of those poor victims. So it's a bittersweet moment this day, and please remember them. And it's a moment of silence and prayer today, I think, and to know that we are so blessed and we are so loved by God, and nothing is impossible, and that He's, no matter all the turmoil we see, we're going to make it, and He gives us strength. So thank you guys for everything, and I love you all. Bye.